जय हिंद स्टूडेंट्स. सो टुडे वी विल बी डिस्कसिंग द इम्पॉर्टेंस ऑफ पैकेजिंग एंड फंक्शंस ऑफ पैकेजिंग. सो होप ऑल ऑफ यू हैव प्रिपेयर्ड योर ओन पॉइंट्स. सो नाउ लेट अस स्टार्ट विद द इम्पॉर्टेंस ऑफ पैकेजिंग. My screen is visible to you all. Yes, yes. No. Okay. So, first point. Please start.
Good morning and afternoon. My name is Soumishree of 12C. I'm here to teach you about importance of packaging. Since packaging has acquired great significance in the marketing of goods and services. I can't see the screen. Thank you. Packaging has acquired great significance in the marketing of goods and services because of the following reasons. So first, rising standards of health and sanitation. We are living in a great pandemic right now, and we know what is the importance of sanitization right now. So because of the increasing standards of living in the country and also the health issues we are facing, more and more people are started purchasing packaged goods as changes of adulteration and such goods are minimizing. So let me just ask you all that which one of the things you will buy now? Many of you will remember that when you go out and you're just thirsty, there are small restaurants or dhabas, they just serve water in a balti with a mug or a cooler. Will you pick that water or you just ask for a mineral water bottle? Tell me.
Mineral water bottle.
Obviously. Why?
Yes, mineral water.
Even though it costs, there's something we think about that is sanitation or nutritious things. Even though water can't be actually adulterated, it can't be mixed with something poisonous. Pani mein hum log kya hi mila sakte hain? Lekin still we just think about health issues because pani se bahut sare diseases bhi phailte hain. Packaging has become essential because riding these rising standards of health, and in packaged goods there are less chances of contamination of products. So people prefer packaged good over loose, or there are less chances of adulteration in packaged goods, and more people are actually preferring these because dono options hamare paas available hain. Obviously jaise ki किसी ग्रोसरी स्टोर पे अभी भी चावल खुला मिलता है, बट उसमें क्या चांसेस है कि उसमें कंकड़ मिले होंगे, और वो क्या चांसेस है कि अगर हम इंडिया गेट का कोई बासमती नहीं भी ले तब भी चावल साफ रहेगा, ज्यादा अच्छा रहेगा. सो दैट इज द माइनर डिफरेंस जहाँ पे राइजिंग स्टैंडर्ड्स ऑफ हेल्थ एंड सैनिटेशन काम करता है. बिकॉज अगर वो अडल्ट्रेशन या कंटामिनेशन नहीं भी होता है तो बस अगर कोई खुला प्रोडक्ट है वो एयरबॉर्न डिजीजेस या फिर डस्ट या फिर किसी भी टाइप का गंदगी अट्रैक्ट कर सकता है. सो दैट लेयर ऑफ प्रोटेक्शन इज नीडेड इन पैकेजिंग. थैंक यू.
वेरी नाइस सौम्या, यू एक्सप्लेन सो नाइसली. यस, सैनिटेशन मींस व्हाट? इट इज रिलेटेड टू द पब्लिक हेल्थ कंडीशन. And public health condition related to what? Like clean drinking water. Then the adequate, you know, treatment facilities. Health, hygiene, all these things are there. Then if you have the proper disposal of all the, you know, wastage of which comes as a garbage from the home, that also will be covered under this. Like the sewage system. This also is considered as the sanitation facility. So all such type of things will come into it, and you are seeing that the health and sanitation facilities growing day by day. People are now more aware of it. So that rising standards has been possible, or it has helped us because of packaging. Now we are getting the packaged food, especially in this pandemic. You have seen the importance of the packaging food, packaged food, right? Because it is considered more safe and healthier. Okay, so now let us talk about the next point.
Jai Hind everyone, I am Adarsh, and I will explain the second point of importance of packaging. That Adarsh, is
say your class and section also.
I am from 12G. I will explain the second point of importance of packaging, that is self-service outlets. In today's time, there is very important that we don't touch products which is touched by other people's hand because of the spread of the virus. The self-service retail outlets are becoming very popular in these days, particularly in the big cities. Because of this, some of the traditional role assigned to the personal selling in respect of promotion has gone to packaging. People prefer product from these stores, and there the consumer need to pick up the products themselves. In this, there are some limitations also, because the consumers cannot get a personal touch from the shopkeeper. But it has many benefits in nowadays. If we don't touch any product but by our hand, we will be safe from the virus spread in the country. Nowadays, self retail shops are becoming very popular in big cities. Thus, a good attractive packaging and a good color scheme, along with eye-catching animated pictures and consumer-friendly, then the consumer would surely pick that product from the shelves. Thank you.
Thank you, others. It was very nice explanation of the self-service outlet. Basically, self-service outlet means what? A shop or an outlet where you can purchase something without being served by another person. There is no one to help you. You yourself is choosing the product, putting it into a basket or a trolley and bringing it at the cash counter and making the payment. That is called the self-service outlet or self-service shop. Nowadays, some of the even restaurant has started this service. You need means a waiter won't come to serve you, but you just have to place the order. You go take it, and then your plates and all those things also, there is a fixed place where you have to keep this back. Even some of the garage also where you can use these services, like aapko tire mein hawa bharwani hai to aap kahin pe ja kar ke paise dete ho, aapke gaadi mein tire mein koi hawa bharta hai. But aapne dekha hoga petrol pump pe aise bhi outlets hain jahan ja kar ke aap khud hawa bhar sakte. ऐसे ही वेरी सून वी विल बी हैविंग द पेट्रोल पंप ऑल्सो. जितना आपको पेट्रोल चाहिए उतना कार्ड से आपने पेमेंट किया, उठाया और अपने गाड़ी में उतने का पेट्रोल या डीजल ले लिया. सो दीज काइंड ऑफ सर्विसेज आर नोन एज सेल्फ सर्विस आउटलेट. बट आप ये देखो, ये सब जो भी ऐसे प्रोडक्ट हैं, एक जैसे ATM मशीन होती है, उसी तरह से कुछ मशीन्स हो सकती है जहाँ से आप कोल्डिंग ले सकते हैं. यू मस्ट हैव सीन सच टाइप ऑफ आउटलेट ऑल्सो. देन देर आर सम सच टाइप ऑफ पॉसिबिलिटीज दैट आपको एक बिस्किट का पैकेट चाहिए, आपने उतने अमाउंट कैश या कार्ड से पेमेंट किया और उतने ही पैकेट्स आपको उस मशीन से निकल करके बाहर आ गए और आपने ले लिया. सो ऑल दीज थिंग्स आर पॉसिबल बट ओनली पॉसिबल व्हेन इट इज पैकेज प्रॉपरली. सो पैकेजिंग एक्चुअली प्लेइंग अ ग्रेट रोल इन प्रोवाइडिंग यू द सेल्फ सर्विस आउटलेट सर्विसेज. ट्रू, यू ऑल एग्री विद मी?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Next, third point.
Sir, may I present my own screen?
Why not? Please.
Good afternoon and Jain everyone. I am Aryan Singh from 12G and I'm going to explain the third importance of packaging, that is innovational opportunity. So let me tell you a story. As you can see here, I have two types of packaging of hair. A long time ago, hairs used to come in tin cans, hair oils used to come in tin cans, as you can see in the left picture. But this possessed a major problem. It was okay in winter season, the oil was usable, but in summer season, due to extreme heat, the oil was completely melted and pouring small amount was too challenging as the whole oil came floating out. But now we have innovative packaging for hair oils. Only a small amount comes out in the winter. If the oil is solidified in summer, then you can open the entire half and make a broad gap for the oil to come out. This was a simple packaging innovation made by oil companies to stand out. The actual oil that is inside the container was not changed. It was just the packaging was changed. Another example is also given in your book about the milk, which can be stored for 4 to 5 days without refrigerators. Innovative packaging can be really convenient for customers to use the product because it helps the customer to store or utilize something which was previously not possible and thus helps to increase the sale. Thank you.
Very nice explanation, Aryan. Very good, very good. There are many such type of product. You said about the milk for 2-3 days. You know, milk in the Tetra pack can be even used for months if it is properly packed. You must have seen such type of product too. No? So it has been possible only because of packaging. That is the importance of packaging. Okay, now let us discuss the next point. Yes, product differentiation, please.
Good morning and Jai Hind everyone. I'm Anshan Singh and I'm from 12G and I'm here to talk about the role that packaging plays in product differentiation. First of all, let's talk about what is product differentiation. Product differentiation is marketing of a similar product with minor differences, which help the consumer to pick among them. So nowadays, consumers are exposed to far greater variety of goods and services than imaginable. Walk into a retail store and you are bombarded with 100 variants of a similar product you might be looking for. So to break through this clutter and make their presence felt is the challenge that most brands face today. And in this situation, packaging helps a lot. Like when you are in a store, you are more attracted towards a quality or different package product of same kind than a product which has a cheap quality of packaging or a common type of packaging. And it also represents the quality of product and the brand of the product nowadays. So it helps the consumers pick between two products.
Yes, Ansanan, that's all. Have you explained?
Yes, sir. There was not much about it to explain. Like,
okay. No, you have explained it very nicely. Good. See, the product differentiation, it basically means what? That it says that packaging helps the consumer as well as the marketer also to differentiate between two products. ना मान लो हम कुछ सामान खरीदने गए सर्विस आउटलेट पे, तो पैकेज देख के ही हमें पता चल जाता है, अच्छा ये ब्रू कॉफी का पैकेट है और ये नेस्कैफे का है ना, दूर से ही आपको देख करके ही समझ में आ जाता है. यस और नो, दिस इज वन थिंग. सेकेंड थिंग दैट इट इज अट्रैक्टिव, इट शुड बी अट्रैक्टिव, मीन्स इट अट्रैक्ट्स द कस्टमर. आप बड़े आसानी से पहचान जाते, तो कोई भी प्रोडक्ट हो उसके केवल पैकेट देख करके आप अंदाजा लगा लेते हो कि दिस प्रोडक्ट इज गुड इन क्वालिटी एंड दिस प्रोडक्ट्स क्वालिटी डजंट सीम सो गुड बिकॉज ऑफ पैकेजिंग ओनली. यस और नो, इट हैपेंस मेनी टाइम्स. यू बाय प्रोडक्ट यू से दैट देखो इसका पैकेजिंग इतना खराब है, ये क्या इसका क्वालिटी अच्छा होगा, है ना. तो पैकेजिंग से ही ना, एक कोई बहुत पुराना शेर है, लिफाफा देखकर ही मजमून भांप लेते हैं. तो दिस इज व्हाट प्रोडक्ट डिफरेंशिएशन इज बीइंग डन बिकॉज ऑफ पैकेजिंग. करेक्ट?
यस सर.
नाउ लेट अस टॉक अबाउट द फंक्शंस ऑफ पैकेजिंग. द फर्स्ट फंक्शन.
गुड आफ्टरनून एंड जय हिंद एवरीवन. This is Shreya Kumari of class 12G, and I'm going to explain the first function of packaging, that is product identification. Okay, so far you have read all the importance of packaging. Hope you have understood it. And now we are moving on product identification, that is functions of packaging. So first let me read and see. Packaging greatly helps in identification of the products. For example, Colgate in red color or Pond's cream jar can be easily identified by its package. Okay, so here it's written like, if there is like with the help of packaging, you can easily identify any product. Let me give you an example. Suppose you want a lace. Lace packet. And there are different chips kept in a shop. So how will you identify a lace packet, that which flavor do you want? Like most of us, we do not know of which color, what flavors comes. So suppose we want that classic salted chips. It comes in yellow color packet. So how will I identify that we wanted that chip? So we'll see, okay, it's yellow color packet and with red labeling on it. So we will we'll come to know, okay, I want this yellow color chips. Now, you will be easily able to identify like this chips is of this flavor and I want my favorite flavor chips. Now, suppose, just imagine a situation, you went in a shop to buy chips. And there are chips kept in four different containers. It's not packed, it's kept in container. Suppose there are Lay's in one container, Pringles in another, and some local chips in the third container, and Uncle chips in the fourth container. So how will you identify that this is, I want the Lay's, so this is Lay's or this is Pringles or any other chips? But if it will be difficult to identify, but if it's packed in a packet, then from far away you will be able identify that, okay, it's a Lay's of blue color or green color or Pringles and I want this. So this is what product identification, that with the help of packaging, how easily you will be able to identify that I want this product. So thank you. And over to
very nice, Shreya. Very good. Very well explained. See, students, all of you, please understand that many a time student complaints are that only this much is written in the book. You know, so just one statement is given here in the book, and how nicely and elaborately she has explained. She has not left nothing to explain for me. So I would not say anything about this first point. Now we'll move to the second point. Thank you, Shreya. Yes, please.
Thank you, sir. Good afternoon and Jai Hind, everyone. I am Adhika Gupta, class 12G, and I would be explaining the next and very important function, that is product protection. So this is one of the very important objectives or the function of packaging. And like, because packaging basically helps to protect the product from any possibility like of any damage, decline in quality or quantity, which can be caused due to anything which it is, like for example sun, rain, dust, which can cause dissatisfaction among the customers. So the product are packaged really in a proper material, and they can be carried from in a long distance, like from one place to another in the right condition. So there are some cases of in which like packaging can increase the lifespan of the product. For example, everyone knows Amul milk, which can last for a lot of days. Thank you.
Thank you, Adhrika. Very well explained. So package is basically, you know, when I said that, I told you the difference of the packing and packaging. So basic idea of packaging was what? Packing. And then we move towards including the labeling and other aspect into it. So obviously it will definitely protect the product first, and then other functions are there. Very good. Next point.
Good afternoon and Jai Hind, everyone. I am Srishti Singh of class 12. To state about the third point of functions of packaging, that is facilitating the use of the product. Talking about the product convenience, we know that the handling of the product becomes more convenient with appropriate packaging, providing convenience in the carriage of the product from one place to another in stocking and consuming. Now let's take an example. Imagine if the toothpaste we use comes in a metal container or a cardboard boxes in place of tubes. It will make you wonder how you're gonna apply it. Thus, it will make the task a little unhygienic and inconvenient, even if the products have been packed. Taking another example, the new PET bottles of Coke makes the carriage and stocking easier. Similarly, the pack of Fruity provides convenience in its consumption. So it brings us to the conclusion that the product should not just be packed, but also packed appropriately to make it convenient to use. Thus, it will facilitate the use of product. Thank you.
Very nice. Well explained. Srishti has given very nice example of putting this, you know, if the toothpaste comes like the packet, like a jam comes into, so it would be very inhygienic as well as very inconvenient also. No, that's why this, and this has been helped by the packaging only. Correct? You all agree?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Next function, please.
Good afternoon and Jai Hind, everyone. I am Shruti Garg of class 12G, and I am going to explain you all about the fourth function of packaging, that is product promotion. Packaging plays a very important role in the promotion of the product, and often success of a product depends on the way its packaging is done. You need to package your product in such a way that it attracts the customers and they prefer your product over other products. Now, there are certain things that can catch your consumer's attention, like the color scheme, the photographs that are present on the product, the typeface, or just the outer appearance of a product. Now, for example, sir, I want to share my screen for the example.
Please share.
Like, for example, you can see that Lay's, they introduced this kind of packaging. So why did they do it? The taste is constant. So why will the consumers prefer this type of meal? Because here the packaging has changed. The consumers will find something different about this product. They'll think that it is different. So that is why they'll prefer this product. And so in this way, your product is promoted. Similarly, you can see that there are two kinds of perfume here. But one perfume is in the shape of a stiletto. So if we assume that the smell of the perfumes is constant, they are same, still the most of the consumers will prefer this product. Why? Because they think there is something different about this product. Hence, packaging indeed plays a very important role in the success of your product. It even helps illiterate people in remembering your product. Thus, sometimes packaging works even better than advertising. And hence, your product is promoted to a great, great extent. Thank you.
Very good, Shruti. Very good. When Shruti has explained, then there is nothing left to add on it. No, wonderful, wonderful explanation, Shruti.
Thank you.
So, in nutshell, we can say the packaging plays the role of advertisement also. Isn't it? This is what you wanted to conclude at, Shruti?
Yes, sir. And sometimes it works even better than advertising.
Very true, very true. So, can someone summarize all these things, whatever we have discussed? These are combined points of the functions and importance. So, it will help you.
Sir, I can summarize the packaging, functions of packaging.
Please, please go ahead.
Jai Hind, everyone. I'm Kritika and I'm going to summarize the functions of the packaging. So, the first function was product identification. Packaging helps in identification of the product, like the color or the jar in which they are packed. So they help in identification of any of the products which we are going to purchase. Second, product protection. Packaging helps in protection of the products, like from any of the spoilage or the breakage or damage which can be caused while storing or distributing of the product or while transporting the products. So it just helps the product from any of the damage or any of the spoilers. The third point is facilitating use of product. So for the consumer, the product whichever they are using, it should be very convenient and easy to handle. The size or the shape of the packing should be such that it could be convenient to open and handle by any of the consumers so that they can easily use it. Fourth, product promotion. Packaging is also used for promotion purposes. It also helps in attracting the attention of the consumers. In sales, like for many, in many of the sales service stores, where you have to get things by yourself rather than serve by others, product promotion is very important. It plays a very, really important role. Thank you.
Very nice. Well explained. Thank you, students, for such a good and very informative as well as very, very useful presentation you all did today. But I would appreciate if you keep your videos on while you are explaining. So next time, please do take care of this. So when we are doing presentation next time, please keep your videos on. Is it okay? any question related to functions and importance of packaging?